Now, Callaway have always been very good at fairway woods, and with the XR range, they're one of the best in the market. Now with the 2016 XR, you've got a fairway wood that's been slightly improved in a couple of ways. There's a lighter, thinner crown, and also the sole has been cambered a little bit more, both left to right and front to back, in order to make it more playable from slightly longer grass. You can probably see there's sort of ridges that go back down either side, and then the general sort of camber from heel to toe is quite generous, I think, and I like that sort of thing in the fairway wood because it gives you a little bit more flexibility. By making the crown thinner, they can drop some weight, more weight into the sole of the club. That improves the forgiveness of the club. And this club has an MOI which is 300 higher than the previous XR. So let's take it onto the range and see how it goes. So here we go with the XR 16 fairway. And when you put it down behind the ball, it's got a lovely look and address. It's like a mid-size sort of fairway, frames the ball very well. I think a lot of players will like this size of head. It's maybe going to suit right up to sort of high 20 handicaps, I think, in that. It's got a nice rounded back to it, and really there's a lot to like about this. And when you swing it, it's such an easy club to launch. The sound and feel is as good as it always is with Callaway clubs. You get a lot of feedback, feels quite light. It kind of feels almost effortless in a way, and it will depend a little bit on which shaft you got in there as well, but there is a wide choice of shafts. There's actually a wide choice of lofts as well. You can go from a strong 3-wood right up to 3, 5, 7, 9 and even an 11 for those people who like those types of clubs, who really need some help. And with that cambered sole, you know, I'm hitting it from the grass here and it's really going through very easily indeed. I've had it out of a few bad lies as well. Really, it's been no problem at all. It's a lovely strong sand and feel whether you tee it up or whether you don't. So I think for a lot of players, this is going to be one of the top fairways in the market, and certainly even some of the pros. But if you do find that a little bit spinny, there's also this pro model here as well. Now this has a slightly smaller head. It's maybe kind of a bit square around the toe as well. It sits a little bit square, a touch squarer as well, but it's still very good indeed. Let's see how this one goes. Now the feel of this is a little bit sharper. It's maybe not as rich or solid, you might say. The flight is a bit lower as well, but it's a good club if you are sort of a high swing speed player or someone who generates a lot of spin. I think for your average golfer, you know, maybe if you're a low handicap golfer in the single figures, this club could be a good option if you want a driving fairway, because I found when I was hitting it from the tee, it just had a little bit more zoom to it. It was easy, obviously, to get a ball up in the air, as you would expect. But I think for a lot of players otherwise, if you're hitting it from the fairway, you're going to maybe find it quite hard work, unless you have that higher swing speed, in which case the standard XR 16 is going to be just perfect for you. That's all for me today. So for more reviews on all Callaway golf equipment, please visit the website at golfalot.com.